Hello, welcome to Big Orbit Games unboxing video of the new Pokemon TCG set XY9 Breakpoint. My name is Simon and I'll be doing the unboxing today. So what I'm going to do is just open this up and then I'm going to get the boosters and we're just going to... Let's have the little stand up. So what I'm going to do is go through the boosters. I'm not going to spend all the time talking about every single like common card, etc. I'm just going to highlight some of the keywords, but I'll just go through each pack and just point out some interesting cards. So no free codes for you there though. So XY9 to Breakpoint carries on the theme from Breakthrough from the previous one. So it introduced these new break cards, which hopefully we'll see one later, but they sort of sit over the top of the regular version of the Pokemon, like an evolution, but they add abilities and increase the HP as opposed to completely overriding it. Got a nice reverse holo Gible there. Pretty cool. I'm going to put the reverses separate. We've got Meowstic. So, Meowstic's an interesting one. Stage 1. Its Psy Shot isn't particularly good. 2 energy for 40 damage. But, for one colorless, attach it with 200 cards from your hand to one of your bench Pokemon. And it's not just basic either. So, this could be double colorless or rainbow energy. So, that's quite a nice one. The energy present. Although, it does have to be your active Pokemon to be able to use that. Sycamore. Everyone loves her. It's our favourite French professor, Sycamore. Gyarados Spirit Link. So, as you can see from the saw from the box earlier, Mega Gyarados is in this set and it's his shiny colour version. Aromatisse. So, good fairy one there. So, just the Dizzying Cologne is the, if your opponent's active, Pokemon is in EX. It does 40 more damage, so a bit of anti-EX there, but we don't mind that, considering how prevalent EXs are. So, Shinx and the Slowpoke. The new Slowking is quite cool, so hopefully we'll see one of those in here soon. Phantom, we have Psyduck. Again, there's a Golduck break. Ah, speaking of, there's a Golduck break. So let's get Psyduck out. So obviously you'd need a Golduck actually evolution on there to be able to do this. And Hypno, cool. But first of all, we'll show you this. So this is the Golduck break. So this goes over the top. Like I said, it'd need to be a Golduck that it goes over, but gives you an idea. So this will go over the top like that and introduce new abilities for it. It's the break version. So goes up to 140 HP and it gains the ability Hyper Transfer. As often as you like during your turn before your attack, you may move a basic energy from one of your Pokemon to another of your Pokemon. So you can't transfer special energy like the new Splash Energy or Double Colorless, but you can use this to move around your basic. So it's an interesting ability, but it's effectively like a stage 2 evolution because of the way the breaks work. So yeah, it's not a terrible one by any measure, but you know, it takes a while to set up. We have Hypno here though, and now for a stage 1, this is fantastic. Only 90 HP on him. His Zen Headbutt's not great, 2 Psychic for 50 damage, but Goodnight Babies, which is also a fantastic name for an ability. Once during your turn before your attack, you may leave both active Pokemon asleep. So this is like a better Hypnotoxic Laser because it's consistent every turn. You don't have to flip for it, it just automatically happens. Now it does put yours to sleep, however there are ways to get around that. Or you might want to leave them asleep, you know, unlikely, but you might want to. But there are ways to get yours, your active Pokemon awake. So yeah, that's a really good ability, Goodnight Babies. I like that one. Tierno Repent. All Night Party. This is a cool one of the new stadiums. Once during each player's turn, if that player's active Pokemon is asleep, like I said, there's ways to get around this, he or she may remove that special condition, heal 30 damage from that Pokemon. So immediately comboing with Hypno there, you can use the All Night Party to wake back up and even heal as a boost. I'll stamp this call as well. So, Mystifying Horn's not great, but for double colourless, so you can do this in one energy drop, 30 damage, but if you have a Mega Evolution on your bench, this does 50 more damage. So you could easily sort of side those into a Mega Evolution deck, get a nice 80 damage attack in. Could be what you need just for that scenario. So we've got Trubbish, the new Garbodor is in here as well somewhere. Hopefully we'll see one of those, although I don't like him. He's quite a nasty, nasty Pokemon. Ah! Garbodor! We've been getting some good pieces here. So, and this is a cool reverse holo as well. So, stage one. His offensive bomb is psychic and three colourless for 60 damage, and your opponent's active Pokemon is confused and poisoned, which is fairly nasty, but not an amazing attack. However, the Garbotoxin is what you're here for, and this is so painful. If this Pokemon has a Pokemon tool attached to it, each Pokemon in play, in each player's hand, and in each player's discard, has no abilities except for Garbotoxin. So this just completely shuts down a lot of decks. Obviously you'd have to build around it because you won't have any abilities either apart from the Garbotoxin, but that is it's absolutely foul. Oh, we got Emboar EX, so our first EX Pokemon for the set. So fire type, the set primarily has water support. I think even up to a quarter of the set is actually support for water type, so he looks out there. But let's have a look at him. 180 HP, Spiral Punch, so a fire and a colorless to do 20 plus damage. Flip a coin until you get tails, it does 20 damage more for each heads. So potential to do a lot, potential to only do 20. And then we have Strong Flare, double fire, double colorless, 150 damage, but discard two energy attached to this Pokemon. Very typical big splashy fire move, but you have to discard as a result. In Breakthrough, though, was the new fire energy, which the special fire energy, burning energy, I believe, which works well with the whole having to discard them thing. So we've looked here. Durant, who doesn't like a bit of mill, discard the top card of your opponent's deck. Very slow mill, but you can do it. And Dunsparce. Yeah, there's a lot of water support in this set, which, to be fair, water needed it for this for the standard meta. Oh, Gibble, so cute. Another Slowpoke, Glammeow, Spritzy. Oh, we've reverse holo Pancham. Fangor's really cool, so hopefully we'll drop into him soon. And put that there. Substrike is interesting to point out, so it's only stage one. It's got the Zap Zone. Damage from the attacks of your lightning Pokemon isn't affected by any effects of your opponent's active Pokemon, which is quite cool. Mitigates a few different things. And then we have Crashing Bolt for double colorless. 50 damage, but if your opponent's active Pokemon has fighting resistance, it does 60 more damage. So it's a little situational, but that 110 damage is very, very nice to have. We have Arcanine, Luxio, Bursting Balloon. This is a cool new item card, so if it's attached to one of your Pokemon, discard it at the end of your opponent's turn. If the Pokemon this card is attached to is your active Pokemon and is damaged by an opponent's attack, even if it's knocked out, put 6 damage counters on the attacking Pokemon. Now this may, because of the attach it to one of your Pokemon, discard at the end of your opponent's turn. So your opponent could just choose not to attack and not take that 60 damage, but then that might be what keeps your Pokemon alive. So Bursting Balloon is very cool, or it can just be used as a go on, hit me, and I'm taking you with me. So I like Bursting Balloon. I think it's a really cool item. If you can run some of the cards that let you get items back out of your discard, then wow, you're onto a winner there, aren't you? So more Psyduck, Gibble, Scroopy. Oh, reverse Shellder. We have Greninja. Greninja has a break in here as well. I think the previous Greninja is a bit better. I think he's my preferred choice because of his ability. And again, if we see the break, I'll explain why. Electrifier. Oh, we have Splash Energy. So this is the new special Water Energy. It can be attached to a water Pokemon and it provides water energy once attached to it. If the Pokemon this card is attached to is knocked out by damage from an opponent's attack, put that Pokemon into your hand. So it's still knocked out in terms of prizes, but you do get the Pokemon back into your hand, which would let you replay it, so you don't lose that Pokemon. So it's not as good, I don't think, as some of the previous special energies for the different types. Oh, it's Pseudowood as well, for the previous special type energies, but it's still, it's quite cool and it's neat. So, and we have a Pseudowoodo, who finally come back into the TCG, but his only ability is Watch and Learn. So if your opponent's notes no damage. If your opponent's Pokemon using an attack during their last turn, use it as this attack. Not good as like a starting Pokemon or a primary attacker, but that's quite cool to be able to use. If you're trying to hit you something nasty, it's useless against things like Nightmarch because of the conditions stated by it, but there could be some interesting ways to get back at your opponent with that. So let's try and flick through some of these common cards, get to the more... Ooh, Fighting Fury Bout, and reverse at that. Another good item from the set. The basic Pokemon's card is attached to gets plus 40 HP, and its attacks do 10 more damage to your opponent's active Pokemon. So it's like a muscle band, but you're getting a HP increase, not just additional damage. So plus 40 HP is really useful to have. It could be the difference between getting a one-hit kill or not. So big fan of Fighting Fury. We have Swissine. I always mispronounce these ones, my apology. As long as this Pokemon is your active Pokemon, prevent all effects of your opponent's attacks except damage done to each of your Pokemon. Existing effects are not removed though. So it's a good little bit of a defensive wall there. You have Arcanine, Pulpitoad, and Cricketune. So, rip into the next one. You have Shouder, Dimple, Ducklet, Glammeow, Spritzy, ooh, Dragalge. So one of my favourite Pokemon actually. So 110 HP. First ability is Severe Poison. So for one psychic, your opponent's active Pokemon is now poisoned, but put 4 damage counters on instead of 1. So that's quite nice. It's a much more powerful poison. And Dragon Pulse for a water and a psychic, 60 damage, but discard the top card of your deck. Sadly, not as good an ability. Pangoro, 120 HP, stage 1 for Pancham. It's Buster Swing, just point this one out. 3 Darkness for 90 damage, and its attack damage isn't affected by resistance. It's a nice punch, but it's not his main thing. You shouldn't ideally be loading him up for that. Parting Shot's what you want. So for 1 Darkness, it only does 10 damage. But switch this Pokemon with one of your benched Pokemon during your opponent's next turn. Any damage done by attacks from the defending Pokemon is reduced by 60. So this is really good for like setting up one of your EXs or something during your turn, say like a Dark Ray. You hit with the Parting Shot for Pangoro, switch to the Dark Ray, much more likely to survive through a one-hit kill potential turn. Boom. Very good. I have a potion, the splash energy, and we have Missy's Termination, one of the new supporters. Discard a card from your hand. If you do, look at the top 8 cards of your deck and put one of them into your hand. Shuffle the other cards back into your deck. It's not a great supporter, unfortunately. The first time I read this, I thought it was, but I somehow managed to miss the discard a card from your hand as well. So, I mean, when we have professors, like Professor Sycamore, Professor Birch and stuff, sadly, Misty's Termination just isn't that good. So, Shouder, Cricketot, Rattata! Who doesn't like Rattata? Oh, Reverse Holo Esper. Pretty. Oh, we have the Golduck with his Derail. Discard a special energy card attached to your opponent's active Pokemon. Only does 20 damage, but that setback could be quite useful. And then Hydro Splash, 3 energy for 70. Not as fantastic. But no downside, at least. Cloyster. We have Frogadier. Oh, we have Reverse Valley, one of the stadiums. We've seen one of these previously, which has 2 sides, and you choose which way around it's facing when it's played. So we'll read this side first. So choose which way it faces. The attacks of this player's Dark-type Pokemon do 10 more damage to your opponent's active Pokemon. Pretty sweet. And any damage done to this player's Steel Pokemon by an opponent's attack is reduced by 10. So it could be very good to have in play if you are running the Dark-types. It kind of shuts your opponent out, adds that extra damage, especially if they, they're not running the steel, they just don't lose or gain from anything. Fentup, Esper, Ducklet, Tofu. Psyduck. Reverse Swanna. Ah, Slowking. Excellent. So, just got the holo version of him. 100 HP. And he has Royal Flush. Once during your turn before your attack, you may flip a coin, and if it's head, move an energy from your opponent's active Pokemon to one of their benched Pokemon. Oh, and he has Psych Up for 2 energy, 40 damage, and during your next turn, this Pokemon Psych Up does 40 more. So, which is quite good, but the Royal Flush, again, is what you're here for. And this is very, very useful ability. I state that because moving an energy around, rather than forcing your opponent to discard it, means they can't even get it back from the discard. You've shunted it onto a Pokemon that can't use it, so, or use it as effectively, so it's like a wasted energy because it's sort of trapped there on that Pokemon. And again, as well, you could use it to force them to discard a card. You, for example, move a dragon energy onto a non-dragon type, etc. So I really like that Royal Flush ability. I think it's really good. Misty's Termination. Swanna. And we have Puzzle of Time. New item for the set. This is quite an intriguing card. So you may play 2 Puzzles of Time cards at once. If you only played 1, look at the top 3 cards of your deck and put them back in any order. So this could be used with like acro bikes and stuff like that. But if you play 2 of them, put 2 cards from your discard pile into your hand. It's fantastic. It's not like just 2 energy or just 2 Pokemon or anything like that. It's any 2 cards. So you definitely want to run them as 4 odds in your deck. Get something, some kind of item recovery in there as well, and you're away. So it's staying. Oh, a little Scrout. Cricketot. Reverse Ferroseed. Camerupt, Electivire, Durant, and we got Pokemon Catcher. Flip a coin, if head, switch one of your opponent's bench Pokemon with that active Pokemon. It's a bit of, obviously, 50-50 whether or not it'll work. Lysandra is the support of Lysandra is a much, it's guaranteed, isn't it, then, so. Esper, oh, normal, that's some adorable artwork. Honedge. Oh, we got a Shift Tree. And in reverse as well. So Dark type for 140 HP. It's a stage 2, so it's a bit of build up to get here. Has Roll Up for 2 energy. Flip 3 coins of any of them ahead your opponent reveals their hand. Then for each head, discard a card from your opponent's hand. So a little bit of a milling strategy there. And for 3 energy, Otherworldly Return, 60 damage. And put a trainer card from your discard pile into your hand. So could be useful to have. I'm going to put that on there. But not amazing for a stage 2. We have Psychic's Third Eye here. So your opponent reveals their hand. You get a bit of knowledge and information of what they're running. Then you can discard as many cards as you like from your hand to draw that many cards. This could see a replacement in certain decks, sort of like in Nightmarch, for example. Replacing a Sycamore because it's a sort of more selective draw and discard, but maybe. We have a Puppy Toad. So, cool. I can see something very shiny at the back there. God, let's just chase to it. Ooh! Reverse Great Ball. Ahaha, Gyarados EX, and a Splash Energy to go with him. So, Gyarados EX, 180 HP, it's his shiny version, as you can see by his redness. First attack is Stormy Seas for 1 colorless. Flip a coin until you get Tails. For each head, search your deck for a Water Energy card and attach it to this Pokemon shuffle your deck afterwards. So he could effectively fill himself with Water Energy. We have Splash Burn, 4 energy, 130 damage, but it does 10 damage to each of your benched Pokemon. Oof, bit nasty there, so bit of a downside. However, with you get the Mega Gyarados EX evolution for him, hopefully we'll see one in here, but all that extra water energy doesn't go to waste. Watch me badly open a booster there. You'd think I'm used to it by now. So, oh, got a reverse foil Lilligrent. That's kind of nice. Ferrothorn, Cedarwood, Bayleaf, and a Max Potion. Yes, Max Potion is back. Heal all damage from one of your Pokemon if you do discard all energy attached to that Pokemon. So, bit of a downside to all that healing. You're going to lose all that energy, but there are plenty of ways to get energy back from the discard. So, or to move it around, say like in a fairy deck, you can move your energy away, heal them, move it back and stuff. So, this downside isn't that much of a downside. Oh, reverse Hunedge, Great Ball, Sizzle Spirit Link. So, Sizzle has a EX and a Mega EX in the set. So, looking forward to seeing that. There's a lot of cards I'd like to see from this booster, and we're nearly halfway through, so I hope we do see some of them. Ooh, Shinx. Pretty. We have a Garbodor again. Frogadier. Vespaluen, Electivire. As I said at the start, I'm sort of blitzing through some of the more common Pokemon cards. Not to say that they're terrible, it's just there's not really a lot to say when they only have one ability. Seismitoad, Nuzleaf. I'm not a fan of the using the little toys, the models, the figures, whichever words you want to use, as the artwork. I much prefer having the actual manga-esque artwork in there. That's just my personal preference. New Shinx, Pancham, Blitzel, Staryu, Perugly, Slowbro, Careless Head, Flip a Coin. If heads, it does 50 more damage, so 10 or 60. And then Walk Off Homer. If you use this attack when you only have one prize card left, you win. It's an alternative win condition. I like that. Might take a bit of staying up to do, but make sure you're not running any EXs to confuse the matter, and Slowbro your way to an alternative win. Oh, we can see there's a nice full card there. Oh wow, that's pretty. So, let's quickly heat more Fighting Fury Baton Cloyster. That is a full art Espeon EX. That is shiny and gorgeous. So, Psychic type, 170 HP, Miraculous Shine. So, one colorless. Devolve each of your opponent's evolved Pokemon and put the highest stage evolution card on it into its opponent's hand. Oof. So, we also have Psyshock, by the way, which is 70 damage for 3 energy. This attack's damage isn't affected by any effects on your opponent's active Pokemon. Again, a fine attack, but at 3 energy, Miraculous Shine. That is such a harsh ability. Devolving all of your opponent's Pokemon, it's a troll card, isn't it? Let's be honest. And you should totally run them if you can. Just devolving them, especially multiples at one time, can really set your opponent back. Especially if it's what they've set up for, like Mega Evolutions, where they potentially already lost turns just from doing that. So Nuzleaf, Goodbye, and All Night Parting. So Mega Sizer EX, 220 HP, and this is Steel type. 120 damage on the Iron Crusher attack. So it takes 2 Steel energy. You can discard a special energy attached to your opponent's active Pokemon or a Stadium card in play. So the 120 is a decent amount of damage. I mean, it's not going to one-shot any other EXs, but it's certainly going to put some hurting on them, and you'll probably be able to finish them off in the next turn. And you might even get to survive through that turn, because forcing them to discard that special energy could get rid of a double colorless or, a dragon energy or something. But also being able to choose whether or not to hit stadium instead is really nice. It's a nice touch because it means it never feels like the ability's been wasted if your opponent hasn't put a special energy card, which is the choice you should always make if you can. But yeah, being able to remove stadium does have quite an impact on some of the other plays, so like on things like fairy decks, which almost rely on having those stadiums in play. So the fighting decks as well. So Trevish, Farsi, Fafu, Koslo, Chigarita, Ratsta. He doesn't like Ratsta. So there's a rat cake break somewhere hiding, so I wonder if we'll see that. So Shinx, ooh, camera, focus again, on edge, Scraup, Aromatis, Hypno. I do really like the Hypno with the, just the name of the ability, Good Night Babies. That alone is just such a fantastically named ability. Ratsa. Ooh, got Dunsparce. And an Aegislash. So Shigilyph, Delinquent as well. So we'll come to Delinquent in a minute. So Aegislash. 140 HP, Psychic type, it's Stage 2. 3 colourless for Painful Sword, double the number of damage counters on each of your opponent's Pokemon. So if you've been using abilities that spread them over their benched Pokemon. And then Megaton Slash, so 4 energy, 2 psychic, 100 damage, and it does 10 damage to 2 of your opponent's benched Pokemon. So it does fit in with the Painful Sword, however the 2 turns to do it, and at Stage 2, and of 100, only with 140 HP for Stage 2. Yeah, you can see the setup for this is going to take a long time, so. And we have Delinquent, another supporter. Discard any stadium card in play, and your opponent discard 3 cards from their hand. So, some decks will find this almost useful to have their cards discarded, but on the whole, this can be a very disruptive card for your opponent. Not only are you removing stadiums, forcing them to discard, could be milling away their key strategies. So, I like Delinquent. I'm not sure how much room I'd make for it, but I do like Delinquent. We have another Scraup, Frogadier, a Reverse Valley. So very similar break so far. And so then I've read that the next set, XY10, I think it's called Fates Collide, will have still have breaks, but they've dropped in the whole break in the name. Like I said, I think it's called Fates Collide or something. Ah, Slowking in reverse as well. That Royal Flush is such a cool ability. Camerupt Bailey for Max Elixir. So Max Elixir, look at the top 6 cards of your deck and attach your basic energy cards you find there to a basic Pokemon on your bench. Shuffle the other cards back into your deck. So obviously remembering that EXs, not the Megas, but EXs count as basics as well. So this is a good bit of energy acceleration for your deck. Then we have Shellder, Kricketot, Rattata, Froakie, Electabuzz, Psyduck. I promise I won't do that again. Frogadier, Lapras, and Max Potion. Makes me happy that Max Potion is back. I've said previously, yeah, it makes you discard all the energy, but fully healing. Oh, so nice. Gabite. 80 HP, Sand Tomb. One fighting does 20 damage, but the defending Pokemon can't retreat during your opponent's next turn. So it does keep them in play, keeps them around, allowing you to hopefully finish them off, or just stopping your opponent from switching out and putting something more powerful in, force them to keep that sort of mediocre Pokemon in play. Oh, we have Raticate, there's Sigilyph, Psychics, and Palpitoad. Raticate, 70 HP, abilities, Antibodies. This Pokemon can't be affected by any special conditions. So it can be good to sit it up front, sort of as a sort of like a wall. And then Dirty Shock, for one colourless. Your opponent's active Pokemon is now poisoned. Discard all Pokemon tool cards attached to that Pokemon. Again, a little bit narrow, but being able to remove a tool from your opponent's Pokemon, like a Muscle Band or a Float Stone, could be something very beneficial to have. So we've gotten a long way through this box, so hopefully we'll see another sort of EX or Froakie. Another EX or break, hopefully. And we've Paul Nicky only makes full art. I can't argue there, can I? Such pretty artwork. Oh, I see a fully foil card there hiding. Wonder which one it is. It's Manaphy! So just quickly, Scizor, Gyarados and Sycamore. The favourite French Pokemon professor. So, Manaphy, like I said, Ward's got a lot of support. Here's Manaphy. 120 HP, Aqua Tube. Each of your Pokemon that has a water energy attached to it has no retreat cost. So not just basic either, by the way. That includes things like Rainbow. A Mineral Pump. Heal 30 damage from each of your bench Pokemon. Now, it only does 60. And again, it's one of these, you probably shouldn't have it up as active and being using the Mineral Pump. What you're here for is to have the Aqua Tube ability to allow you to switch stuff in and out. If we'd seen him, and I don't think we're going to at this rate, the Greninja Break has an amazing Water Shuriken ability where you can discard water energy cards to deal 60 damage. And it's not an attack, it's an ability. Now, if catches, it has to be active. So if you had Manaphy in play, yeah, hopefully you've immediately seen it. You can switch Greninja into active, use his ability to deal 60 damage, retreat it back using Manaphy free retreat ability, and put your actual hitter into play as it's active. And the other Greninja you've braked onto him, the one from the things from Breakthrough, also has the same ability, but for dealing 30. So you can deal 90 damage before you've even attacked. So, needs a bit of setup, but then what strategy in Pokemon doesn't need some setup? Clefairy, Slowpoke, Drowsy, Phantump. Grapion, Great Ball, and Dewblade. I really like the whole Dewblade and Edge Slash. Edge Slash is another one of my favourite Pokemon. A lot of people I know don't like him, but tough, I do. Chowdash, Seedot, Timpole, Trubbish, Swissine, Luxray, Luxio, Durant. One thing I haven't seen, I heard that there were some printing errors and some generation cards that sneaked through in the uncommon slots in some of these boosters. Now, it's possible I've missed one, but I haven't seen one, unfortunately. It would have been cool to get one on camera. Corsola. Meganium. I always mispronounce these things horribly. So because of the set having so much water love, grass is, you know, good against that. So here we have it's stage 2, 150 HP, abilities overgrow. If its remaining HP is 50 or less, its attacks do 70 more damage to your opponent's active Pokemon, which would make Green Force 120. Enough to one-shot a lot of stage 2s. And then 3 energy, heal from this Pokemon the same amount of damage you did your opponent's active Pokemon. So you're not going to be able to keep repeating the whole overgrow thing, but it'll allow you to get it off as a one-shot. Hopefully killing off your opponent's Pokemon, they're active, and force them to switch in an inferior benched Pokemon. Seedot, Furfoo, Slowpoke, we have Luxio, Clefable. What's Clefable do? So, oh yes, Clefable. So, Moon Barrier, one fairy, does 30 damage. During your opponent's next turn, prevent all effects of attacks, including damage, done to this Pokemon by Dragon type. So it's a Dragon type hoser, basically. And we have Tumbling Attack, which is 3 energy, 50 plus, flip a coin of heads, it does 30 more. So there's no downside, which you'd imagine from a tumble, but just a positive, potentially doing more. But the Moon Barrier is cool just because it nerfs Dragon types. Because, you know, they needed nerfing, apparently. And they needed someone to stand up against them. And Clefable was the chosen one. So, there's a break. Trevenant. So, just quickly, the Puzzle Time, Arcanine and Poppetoad. So this is the break for Mr. Tree Man. Ups his HP to 160 and grants him Silent Fear. So one psychic and colorless. Notice no damage, but put 3 damage counters on each of your opponent's Pokemon. Not just one, And not just the active and one benched, it's all of them. All of them take that much damage. Combine that with one of the Pokemon whose name has just escaped me, whose ability allows you to move damage counters around. Absol, which is one of the dark ones. When you play him, you can move damage counters. You can start, you know, picking and choosing who you snipe off on their bench, which is always a neat thing to be able to do. So, penultimate pack. Ooh, I see. I think there's a full art trainer there. That is a full art Skylar. Very cool. We also got a reverse Chikorita. So, Pokemon Catcher and Perugly there. So, that's very nice. Full art card there. So, Skylar, search your deck for a trainer card, reveal it and put it into your hand, shuffle your deck afterwards. Unfortunately, not a fantastic one because you can only obviously play one support per turn. But it could be useful to get that exact card you need rather than just blindly drawing. If what your deck needs is just to be able to search that one specific card, Skylar's your girl. That's two full arts from the set. So, final booster from the box. Cricketop, Drowsy, a Growlithe, Clefairy. I said I wouldn't do that, sorry. Froakie. Oh, we've got Garchomp. So we also had a Seismitoad, Tierno, All Night Party, and a Stantler. Garchomp's cool. He's got 130 HP, which is low for a stage 2. But Turbo Assault for one fighting, 60 damage, and attach an energy card from your discard pile to one of your Pokemon. And again, that's not a basic, that's any energy card to any one of your Pokemon. So you could use it for Garchomp to activate Bite Off, or just use it to bump up, say, like if you're running fighting, you're probably running Machomp EXs and stuff. So use it to buff those up ready for when he dies. But Bite Off, two fighting, 80 plus. If your opponent's active Pokemon is an EX, it does 80 more, so 160 in total. So this is an EX hosing card. The stage 2 is a bit of a downside because it does require you getting that setup time to get ready, during which an EX is already probably active and smashing through your Pokemon bench. And the 130 HP is a bit low, makes it a bit weak, but hopefully you can get that Bite Off straight away and boom, take out their EXs. So there we go. That's all the packs are open for this breakpoint. So in terms of what shiny stuff we pulled, so we got a Golduck and a Trevenant break cards. Then we got a Manaphy, Mega Scizor, Gyarados EX, and an Emboar EX. Shame, I really would like to have gotten the break Greninja, but can't complain about everything. And then we got two full arts in here. So we got a Skylar and an Espeon EX. Both of them were quite pretty artwork, quite nice. So yeah, I like those. And then obviously lots of reverse holos, which are always nice to have in your collection. Lots of those. So yeah, as a set overall, Breakpoints carried on sort of what Breakthrough was doing. It's just mostly supported the water type and it did need the support. There's also some really good trainer cards in here. So even if you're not planning on building water decks, there's definitely some cards in here for you. Like the Fighting Fury Bout and Max Potions if you haven't got a hold of any already. So good to see those in here. So yeah, overall, I really like the Breakpoint set. I'm looking forward to Fates Collided. Because they are continuing the breaks, so we'll see what else they do with them. And I believe it also supports psychic types, so it's going to be cool. But yeah, so Breakpoint, good set overall. Lots of stuff in there for lots of different decks, despite the big focus on the water. It didn't mean when we did the pre-release that a lot of players were playing with just pure water decks, so the sort of the sealed play for it's not great, but then you really only do that on pre-release with Pokemon anyway, so there we go. So yeah, so remember all the cards you've seen here today can be bought and sold on our website, bigorbitcards.co.uk. Remember to like and subscribe. Join me in future for more Pokemon unboxings. I hope you've enjoyed watching. Any comments or questions, just leave them in the comments below. and I will see you next time. Bye.